coming off a dominant 23-point victory, the Stockton Ospreys look to hold on to the top spot in the NJAC as they welcome a North Jersey foe to Atlantic County as they host the Ramapo College Roadrunners. It's NJAC basketball on the Stockton Sports Network. Hello and welcome to Galloway. Garrett Lee with you from Jerry Matthews Court as the 13-3 Ospreys welcome in the 4-10 Roadrunners. Two teams in NJAC play have been really polar opposites. The Ospreys come in at 8-2 in conference play, and then the Roadrunners come in at 3-7 in the New Jersey Athletic Conference. Been polar opposites all year round. Stockton, you know, in the men's basketball landscape has been fantastic for a couple of years now, and this year is no different. A look to take this one, and just based on records, they're got to get a little bit on the same page because they have a big game coming up against Rowan on Wednesday. A little look to take this one today. Look forward to that South Jersey matchup later on in the week as they'll travel across Route 322 for a battle with the Profs. Two teams at the top of the NJAC as of tip-off. As of right now, the Profs go up to Union. They'll play Kane University in just a little bit as well. But you can't look too far ahead as, sure, record-wise, this Ramapo squad doesn't look as tough, but they're young, feisty, hungry squad looking to get an upset victory. For Stockton, they'll look to DJ Campbell to be the guy, averaging nearly 18 points a game and 5.2 boards per game, both near the top of the NJAC in those categories. For Ramapo, they have struggled this year. That hasn't really been out of the question. 4-10, 3-7 in the NJAC. It's obvious they've had some issues, but really one of the team's hardest hit by the season last year. They were one of the teams that didn't play last year. Stockton did, as many know, finishing the second with a loss to NJCU in the NJAC title game for the second straight year. But for Ramapo, didn't play last year, and they've had to completely rebuild this roster as now it's very, very, very underclassmen heavy. And the starting lineup consistently is four freshmen. So that just proves how young and hungry this team is to go out and get victories. But if they're going to get a victory today, they're probably going to look for one of those senior leaders and most likely captain Marquise Kindle, who's been fantastic on the year. 11 points per game, 7.5 rebounds, just over 7.5 rebounds. He gets it done on the glass. Second in the conference in boards per game. He's already shown he could be a difference maker in the NJAC, and we'll look to continue that here today for the Roadrunners. Stockton, like we mentioned, has been fantastic as of recent. History in the New Jersey Athletic Conference, 8-2 in conference this year. They're coming off back-to-back NJAC finals appearances, however, 0-2 in those two games. So it's been a struggle for the Ospreys to go and get some victories in the NJAC, at least when it comes down to big time. However, the Ospreys this year, we said, have been very good. They're coming off back-to-back victories against the Rutgers Gauntlet, taking down Rutgers Newark and Rutgers Camden in the past week. Go look at this one again. Take a look at the series history between these two squads, between Ramapo and Stockton. Two teams with plenty of experience. Last time they faced off was up in Mahwah last month, where the Ospreys took that one in a close one, 69-66, your final score on December the 4th. The Roadrunners fell in that one. The Ospreys hold the series lead 32-27, and really they've gone back and forth the past couple of matchups, but a six-game win streak for the Ospreys was broken in 2019, so Stockton will look to try and start another one as we're just about ready for tip-off. We'll get the national anthem, starting lineups, and more in just a little bit. Don't go anywhere. More Stockton basketball on the Ospreys Sports Network.
Okay, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3.
Welcome back to Jerry Matthews, Corey Gardley with you for this matchup between the Ramapo College Roadrunners and the Stockton University Ospreys. We get to starting lineups for both sides. Ramapo led by the senior guard out of East Orange, New Jersey, Marquise Kendall, who's been fantastic on the year. Second in rebounds in the end, Jack, as well. Peter Gorman, Shane Rooney, Justin Bladen, and then in the middle, Jordan Myers, the freshman, 6'5" out of Piscataway, New Jersey. Four freshmen in this starting lineup for the Roadrunners. On the other side, same as it's been all year long, running four guards, one forward. The one forward in the front court, Nick Dunsack, will lead the way, the junior from Toms River, New Jersey. And then you have Ryanell Lawrence, Cadian Dawkins, Kion Flanders, and DJ Campbell, the junior guard from Vineland, New Jersey. As here, Dawkins kicks it out for Flanders. Flanders now top of the key, driving inside. It was Lawrence. Lawrence with a fadeaway shot, can't go. That one's off the mark. And we're underway from Galloway. Gorman takes things top of the key, will give off. Simple give off back to Gorman now. in the corner. We'll try and drop things down, but a travel is called. And it's Bladen, so nothing going on the first two possessions for either side. Take a look at the head coaching matchups for both sides. Scott Bittner for Stockton in his sixth season as a head coach with the Ospreys, 16th season overall in Atlantic County. On the other side, Chuck McBreen, who turned the program around during his time with the Ospreys, 23rd season with Stockton. Block from three-point range, but Campbell gets it back. Campbell will take a pull-up jumper from the elbow. Can't go. Offensive board by the Ospreys. Back out. Campbell, three ball. Again short that time, but another offensive board for the Ospreys. Campbell will drive in now, and that one's off the mark as well. Finally, a rebound for the Roadrunners. They'll take this one the other way. Trying to drive inside, and a reach-in foul called against Campbell. He's having a rough start to this one. Campbell 0 for 3 to start the ball game. 0 for 4, excuse me. Add one more to it. Dishes off. Here's Bladen. Bladen back top of the key for Gorman. Gorman will try and drive baseline. Will pull up with a spinning fadeaway shot. It's off the mark. Rebounded by Dunzak, who dishes things out. Dawkins. Now Dunzak for three. Got it! On the board to start the game. Nick Dunzak makes it 3-0 Ospreys. The other way, quickly answered by Kendall. Talked about Kendall. He's going to be the difference maker for Ramapo. They want to get a victory here today. Flanders gives off to Dawkins, back over Dawkins, run a little pass and pass. Lawrence will drive, and he gets fouled. Two from the free throw line here. Took a little bit of time to get going, but now we're seeing a little bit better offense from both sides. Talk about other games going on in the NJAC, one that Stockton definitely wants to keep an eye out for is the Rowan Kane game. Two more competitive teams in the New Jersey Athletic Conference as the first free throw off the mark just tipped off a few minutes ago. It's a 7-2 lead for the Profs up in Union. Elsewhere, Montclair State and TCNJ will be facing off against each other. Montclair State with a slim 2-point lead, only around 3 minutes in. One from the line there. Makes it a 4-2 game. Still in favor of the Ospreys. Gorman. Gorman dishes things across to Bladen. Expect to see these starting fives on the floor a whole lot. Especially for Ramapo, a team that doesn't make many substitutions. Isn't as deep as they're very young. Gorman, the long pass inside. Too hot to handle. And it's a turnover going the other way. Ospreys' high-powered offense has yet to get going so far. Dunzak pull up three ball. That one's short. Rebounded by the Roadrunners. Running in transition. Gorman will have to slow things down as it's well covered. Out to the corner. Now other side corner. Bladen pull up from the free throw line. Off the mark as well. So another miss. Campbell takes things here. Campbell dishes off. The Lawrence. Now back to Campbell for three. Can't go. Dunzak, big board inside, met by a triple team, and just floats it up and connects. Dunzak has five. Ospreys team, second in field goal percentage in the NJAC. Third in three-point percentage, but today, early on, can't find a way to get it to go. Jordan Myers gets called for the travel there. A substitution as right now Lawrence will check out. And Alan Glover, a junior from Plymouth Meeting, Pennsylvania, will check in. And Ramapo, a team that is very underclassmen heavy in the last contest against William Patterson. Only had three upperclassmen play for three. Can't go that time. Top of the key, 4 minutes down. Almost intercepted, spinning around. Driving in, puts up the floater. Blading off the mark as well. Now 2-on-1, looking for the lob, the layup in transition to Campbell is good. It's an 8-2 lead for the Ospreys. Timeout called. We're going to keep things here. It's timeout called by Rampo that time. A little bit of a run there for the Ospreys, but still a lot of missed shots on their past couple of possessions. 3 of 11 from the field right now. Good for 27%. They shot the ball from beyond the arc 6 times already, only hitting 1. A team that really makes their shots simple as that. Second in the NJAC in field percentage, 46%. And then from deep, right there as well, second in the NJAC, 37% from beyond the arc. Just so far finding it a little bit tough to get things going offensively. For Ramapo, they struggle to put points on the board. Eighth in points per game for themselves, but they allow the second most points per game, around 74%, against a Stockton team that knows how to score pretty efficiently, and very aggressive offensively. Things can get crazy if you let it. Myers dishes out over to Blade. Now Gorman with it, picks up his dribble, nothing going, gives inside, spin move with a fadeaway hook off the mark from Myers. So again, here come the Ospreys the opposite way. Dawkins drops things inside for Williams, who recently checked in. Williams backing things down, spins around, a little sky hook, goes down. 8-point lead for the Ospreys. That might be where the Ospreys have to funnel things in. Down low, they've worked really well with Dunzak, and then Williams right there got the job done as well. Top of the key. Kendall hops that, loses control, and a hit off him, out of bounds. Two substitutions come in for Ramapo. Mansfield Warren checks in as well as Julian Diamond. Both did not play in their last contest. Gorman working here with a 10-point advantage. Kendall, opposite side, gives off. Trying to run a play, looking for a screen. Gorman fakes the pass. Outside, still no shot being taken. Will drive, working inside, puts up the shot. Can't go. Long pass down court to Campbell. Campbell in the corner, he pulls up. Off the back iron, no good. Another offensive rebound. Here's Dawkins. Will give off to Flanders. Flanders back to Dawkins, down low. And an off-ball foul called on Stockton. A little against Alan Glover, I believe. Milo De Los Santos will check into the ball game for the Ospreys. So far, still not many shots taken from Ramapo. Kendall against the screen. Look to drop things down. Good defense by the Ospreys. Gorman, working. Spin move, hop step, gives inside, and a foul call, so two shots coming up. So Campbell's second of the game already. A bit of trouble in the early stages. Expect the substitution, only 7 minutes down. Kendall, that's the first one. Ends a 4.5-minute scoreless drought for the Roadrunners. Campbell checks out as Zoro checks in, again trying to get a little bit more size. Two players over 6 foot five currently on the floor for the Ospreys. Williams checks things in. Now gives off to Lawrence. Back over Dawkins, back over Lawrence. Lawrence picks up his dribble. Inside Williams, three on two. Gave it up to De Los Santos. Now Dawkins back with it. Dawkins looking to try and drive towards the block. Now will work, spin move, met by a double. Outside, Williams, stop, pop, three, on a line. And off the front of the rim. Gorman looks to drive, got it swept away. Now opposite side, Corbo. He just recently checked in, driving inside. Now outside, tried to get the pass out to Gorman again. Can't connect on it. A usually disciplined team in Ramapo leads the NJAC in field goal percentage, which means they make their shots and they get high quality looks, but today hasn't been that. Little jab step, drived inside, and then a foul called. Lawrence again will go to the line. First free throw, up and good. Lawrence, a 78% shooter from the charity stripe. Nets that first one. Ramapo going up against one of the best turnover teams in the NJAC. Williams with a big offensive board. Got the first one, tried to put the second chance point back up, couldn't go. Working here, here's Warren. Warren dishes things out to Corbo. Corbo, spin move, swiped away. Outside, here's Gorman. Gorman will work. Crossover, drives inside. The layup rattles out. Can't go, in transition. Here's Lawrence. Lawrence to Williams, now to De Los Santos. Williams again. Give off Lawrence. Lawrence, De Los Santos, stop, pop, Trey. Too short. The three ball hasn't been there so far for Stockton, 1-for-9 unofficially. Mansfield to the cup, gets it go. Warren connects. Cuts the deficit to 7. Warren for 3, got it. Williams connects on that one. Jordan Williams from deep. Gorman trying to get the pass inside, strung too far out. Gorman again will give off Corbo. Corbo, nice feet underneath, gets it blocked away, but a foul called. So Zoro called for the foul there. Two shots for the line at the line here. Brian Joseph. Joseph, another underclassman for Ramapo, the freshman out of Jersey City, Hudson Catholic High School. Swarm substitution for the Ospreys there. Highlighted by Kion Flanders checking back in. Second free throw up and good as well. It's an 8-point game, 16-8. Around 11 minutes to go in the first half of basketball. Flanders outside, Dunzak for 3. Stretches right back out. And no good. Other way. Warren tried to drop it down. Pass got tipped away. Warren still with it, saves a turnover there, but forces one on the opposite side. And then a foul. Assist against Ramapo. Corbo got called for the reach there, kind of just trying to avoid the easy transition bucket. Not a clear path foul, but so good move. Flanders dishes outside. Still working on the perimeter. Dawkins, now out. Flanders, long three, connects. Caden Dawkins with a good find there. It was a smart play, working elbow to elbow. Corbo gets the screen, pop around it a few times, still not rolling. Good off-ball defense trying to get after it. Now in the corner, Rampo will pull, rattles out, offensive board by Kendall. Puts up the shot, gets fouled. Kendall goes to the line here, shoot two. That's on the first one. Roadrunners 5 for 5 from the line to start the game. Kendall, a 60% free throw shooter on the year. Hits on the second one, a perfect trip to the line. That's been typical for the Roadrunners here today. Working things around, Dawkins now to Dunsack, over to Flanders, back to Dawkins. Dawkins gets a screen, will drop things down. Dunsack, top of the key, fake the three. Now outside again, good defense here by Ramapo. As the shots look open, then they're not. Poked away by Corbo. Corbo in transition. Even break, gives off, the pass underneath. Foul called before the bucket, and they're gonna call a charge. Great job underneath to get the take. And Corbo gets called for the charge there. His third of the game. 9-point lead for the Ospreys. Johnson will work here. Dunsack over to Johnson. Drop down low. Operating is Glover. Glover outside. Johnson again. Will stop, pop, Euro step. The ball swiped away and a foul. A lot of fouls so far. Kendall called for the violation that time. Both teams have 5. Johnson will shoot 2 here. Take a look at games going on elsewhere in the NJAC. Part of the season where you love to match things up. However, seeding will still matter, but all 10 teams in the NJAC will receive a berth this year due to games being canceled due to COVID with a lot of programs. But so far, Montclair State with a 12-point lead, 25-13 over TCNJ in Montclair. Elsewhere in Union, the Profs hold a 29-20 lead over Kane. Around 10 minutes left to go in the first half. Elsewhere to go on today, NJCU, New Jersey City University, the Gothic Knights traveling down to South Jersey to take on Rutgers Camden. And then Rutgers Newark and William Patterson will face off later on today as well. 11-point game in this one. Warren with a good fake, drives inside towards a triple team. The layup with a whole lot of contact can't go. Facing after it, Rampo calls a timeout. It's a 30-second timeout. They'll keep possession. So far, it's been a lot of Rampo just can score on the outside, really can't score anywhere but the paint, it seems, as of right now. Only three players with points. Kendall Joseph and Warren, and Kendall leads the way with six. Leads the way for the Roadrunners with six, doesn't lead the game. That goes to Jordan Williams with seven, 3 of 5 from the field. He's been operating through the bigs so far today for the Ospreys. Nick Dunsack and Jordan Williams combined for 12 points alone. Those two outscore the entire Roadrunner squad. Combined 2 of 5 from the field as well. 2 of 5 from beyond the arc, excuse me. As Ramapo just hasn't been able to get quality looks at the bucket. Another one there. Too strong, but a foul called. As Glover's called for that one on the shot. Two free throws coming up. And that's where a bulk of Rampo's points have came from. More than half of the Roadrunners' points have come from the line. Now 7 of 7 from the charity stripe. Perfect start from the line. As Isaiah Hall at the line here for the Roadrunners. Cuts the deficit to 10. First miss from the line for Ramapo on the day. 7 of 8 from the charity stripe now. 2 of 10 from the field to start the ball game. Campbell trying to call ISO, will pull up with the long two. It can't go. Wood taking it, trying to save it. They do. Beautiful play to keep it together. Campbell will drive. Blocked at the cup. The block won't stand. As Hall called for the foul, and now some extracurriculars going on after the play, but looked like a beautiful come from behind chase down block. Won't stand. Head coach Chuck McBreen of the Roadrunners is visibly frustrated about it. So Campbell connects on the first one. Campbell hits on his first trip to the line. He's had a tough start today. 1 of 8 from the field, 0 of 4 from beyond the arc, and now only 3 points as he goes 50% from the line there. 1 for 2. 7:45 left to go in the first half. Rolling pass inside. Hall will put up the floater. Drops down and good. Trying to run in transition. Dawkins will have to slow things down. Dawkins crosses the timeline. Now gives off Flanders. Flanders run all the way back to Dawkins. Dawkins, now to Lawrence. Lawrence, outside again. Jab step, drop back, will drive inside, and a foul. A lot of shots from the line for both sides in the early stages. 16 combined free throws for both sides. Each have 8. 7 made for Ramapo, 5 so far made for the Ospreys. First free throw connects on that one. Flanders, 70% free throw shooter on the year, has been a big part of the Ospreys' success as of recent years. 2-time All-NJAC selection, a first team bid in 2019. Finished 7th in the NJAC in steals that year. And then last year in the COVID shortened season, 2nd team on the All-NJAC squad. And looking to add another All-NJAC selection this year. Gorman. Gorman outside. Dish one more time. Step back, picked up his dribble. Had to give down low again. Outside for three. Connects. The three goes that time for Howell. Makes it 24-16, still in favor of the Ospreys. Dunzak to answer. Off the back iron, no good. Dribbling things up. We'll give off Howell. Howell will drive. Looking to kick out. Finds himself free, but had to give back out. Gorman. Gorman, Kindle. Kindle, pull up Jay. Not strong enough. Off the mark, too short. 6 minutes left to play. Long three. And it's wedgied. Won't go, we're gonna have to poke this one down. Yeah, did not take many tries to get it down, so that's always good. We get a little fist bump. Deserved, well deserved. Your time calls, you know? They call your number, you gotta step up. That's what just happened. That's what every floor mopper, that's what you look for. That's your moment. You have to get it down with the broom. No, everybody in the stands, everybody here looking for you. Back to live action. Howell gives off Gorman. Gorman outside. The dish off. Long pass opposite side to Howell. Howell will have to do something here. Try to pass it inside. And it's swiped away. Taken in by Dawkins, who gives up the court to Flanders. Back over Dawkins. Dawkins working from the logo. Long pass across to Lawrence. Dunzak now. Dunzak will give off. Again, Lawrence pulls up corner. Three. Well off the mark going the other way. Another loose ball foul. I believe called against Jordan Williams that time. So we'll reset. And in the bonus, so 1-1 upcoming. Brian Joseph will again head to the line. He's 2-for-2 on the day. Connects on the first. Make him 3-for-3 on the ball game. 7-point lead now for the Ospreys, 24-17. Stockton leads. We said on the last free throw trip. Scores around the NCAC always do matter. The regular season does matter, but only in terms of seeding, as every team this year will make the NCAC tournament. So if you're Stockton, you look at things around the NCAC. They dish things around a couple times. Williams sets the screen. Now outside, Campbell, Trey, again off the mark. Believe it hit off an Osprey, but got batted around too many times. It's too tough to tell, so Campbell will inbound. Campbell gives outside to Williams, and they'll set up a play here. Dawkins to drive, spin move, puts up the sky hook, can't go. And then last touch, Williams was trying to get the offensive board, it goes off him. This year, due to the COVID cancellations, every team will make the NJAC tournament, recently announced by the conference. But if you look at things around the NJAC, when it comes down to seeding, there's teams you'd much rather want to play. Stockton currently holds the number one seed in the NJAC, and that means they would play Rutgers-Camden. Rutgers-Camden winless on the year. 0-for-10 in conference, 0-13 overall. You'd rather play them than a Ramapo or TCNJ squad, who Ramapo staying competitive in this one, only a 6-point ball game, and then TCNJ, who can go out and get upsets at any given moment as well. Just 2 years removed from an NJAC title. Means these next two games for Stockton mean a whole lot. Campbell gives outside. to Flanders. Flanders to drive, puts up a little baby hook, and connects. 8-point game. These next two or three games really mean a lot. They will travel across 322 to go up against the Prowse of Roan University, who sit at 7-3. Third in the NJAC. Right by the leaders, Rutgers North and Stockton. Good feet on the opposite side. We give off Campbell. Campbell working on the perimeter. We'll pull up. Long tray. Drops it in. From deep, DJ Campbell pulls up with the trifecta and makes it a 9-point game. Gorman looking for an answer. Dishes out, now Howell. Howell on the perimeter, drops things down, spin move to the cup. A good move, gets it to go. Myers connected on that one. Cuts the deficit to only 7 now. 3:10 left to go in the first half. Dishes outside. Flanders pump fakes. Has to give off once more. Dawkins outside operating. 10 on the shot clock. Gets a screen from Williams. Dawkins. Off to Campbell. Another one. Can't take the second hop in. Long pass to Gorman. Gorman will slow things up now. Under 3 to play. Give off Myers. Gorman again. Looks for a screen, now a backdoor cut, it's not there. Kendall, outside Howell, stutter step. Again, they'll reset, screen set. Gorman, pull up, mid-range shot. Off the mark, and the ball will stay here. They'll say last touched by Williams of Stockton. Azzurro checks in for the Ospreys. Another substitution will come in for Ramapo. Shane Rooney checks in. Brian Joseph will hop out of the ballgame. Rooney averaging almost a double-double, around 9 points per game and 7.5 rebounds. Myers with it down low. Try and body his way in. Post hook, can't go. Offensive board, no. Things will hop the other way. So Flanders will take things off the inbound. Scratch that, give it right back to Dawkins. Dawkins hopping around, gets it past half court. Now Campbell. Campbell gets it swiped away, but right back on top of it is the junior guard, Campbell. Again, trying to operate from deep. Tried to get the hop step. Got fouled. He'll go to the line here for a 1-1, I believe. Ninth of the ball game on Ramapo, so 1-1 here. 7-point ball game as Campbell has had a tough day from beyond the arc, from the field in general. Only 2 of 11 on the day, 1 of 7 from beyond the arc. They like him to pull it, can usually hit. He's fourth in the NJAC and 3-point percentage. Around 40%, but today, not seeing a 40% shooter. Also tied for third in the NJAC from the charity stripe, hit both right there at around 87%. Campbell will pop out. Right now, Lawrence will come back in. On the floor, Dawkins, Flanders, Lawrence, Azzurro, and De Los Santos. The other side, Myers, Gorman, Rooney, Kendall. As the shot missed that time by Rooney. De Los Santos to answer with a 3. Can't go, loose ball foul. Ball will stay with the Ospreys. 9-point game, minute and 30 is. Myers gets called for the foul that time. So now two shots from the line here. or Zora. Hits on the first. Azuro connects, makes it a 10-point game. Jamar Johnson will check in for Neil Santos. Two for two from the line. Successful trip that time for Jonathan Azuro. Makes an 11-point game with a minute and a half till the break. Gorman dishes inside, the pass, last touch by Stockton, tried to get it over. As Lawrence kind of got tangled with the ball there, went over cheerleaders along the baseline. And underneath, Myers gets things off the inbound. Now to Rooney. Rooney, Gorman. Gorman now. Venezia. Gorman working, trying to go around. Nice move to free himself up, but the mid-range shot can't go. Second chance effort off the backboard as well. Trapped inside. They finally get the pass off, and Stockton will take it the other way. 50 seconds left to go in the half, and a foul called. As Dawkins will go to the line here for two. So Dawkins again will get another, will get his first trip to the line. Feels like everyone's had a trip to the line in today's game, but Dawkins' first trip, his first chance to get points, connects on the first. Dawkins is becoming a big focal point in the offense, at least manning the offense this year after coming off the bench the last two seasons. And a big part of the Ospreys' success. Gorman gives things across. He gets it right back. Venezia outside. Kindle driving inside. He's fouled. Another whistle blows as Johnson's call for the foul that time. Kendall will shoot a 1-1. Only 8 team fouls for the Ospreys. Hits on the first. Kendall leads all scorers, tied with DJ Campbell for leading all scorers with 8 points. Chance to take that lead right here. And he does. So now leads the game with 9 points. Only 2 of 3 from the field, but 5 of 5 from the charity stripe. And the wizard on the line today. Dawkins. Shot clock not quite unplugged, but pretty darn close to it. 11 on the shot clock, 11 on the game clock. They'll hold the final shot. Dawkins setting up a play now. We'll give outside. Los Santos driving in outside. We'll have to chuck it up at the buzzer, and it won't go. Shot is off the mark at the buzzer, but the Ospreys hold a big lead going into the break. 11-point lead for Stockton, 35-24 as we head to the intermission. Take a look at the stats for both sides. Starting off first for Ramapo, they've struggled to get things going offensively. 28% from the field, but in that 28%, only 6 makes and 1 of 2 from beyond the arc. Haven't had a lot of shots from the field to begin with. Have made their money from the charity stripe. 11 of 12, 91% as a team. Highlighted by Marquise Kendall's 10 points, 6 of 6 from the free throw line, and 4 rebounds to go along with that. On the other side, they're led by DJ Campbell. 8 points, but really shooting the ball hasn't been the most efficient. 2 of 11 from the field, 1 of 7 from beyond the arc, 3 of 4 from the free throw line. Leads all scorers for the Ospreys with 8. Also, Jordan Williams with 7 points, 3 of 5 from the field, 1 of 2 from deep tied with Keon Flanders with 7 points as well. Kane Dawkins and Nick Dunsack lead the way in rebounds, both with four, tied with Marquise Kendall. It's four for the game high in this one. We come back, we'll have second half action and a look around the NJAC in just a moment. More when we return on the Stockton Sports Network.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the Stockton University cheerleaders.
I want to get it.
Welcome back to Stockton University as the Ospreys hold an 11-point lead as we head to the second half of action. 35-24, the Ospreys lead the Roadrunners in this NJAC contest. Like we said, Stockton top of the NJAC as of right now, but a lot can change based on today. Big matchups to watch, at least going on currently. Rowan and Kane, the Pros, have gone out to a big lead, 51-34. That one just about to enter the second half of play. And then later on tonight, or later on this evening, Rutgers Newark travels up to Wayne. Short little travel for Rutgers Newark. Play the Wayne-Patterson Pioneers. That one set to tip off at 3 p.m. Elsewhere in the NJAC, currently a 4-point lead, around 3 minutes down in the second half for Montclair State Redhawks. They lead TCNJ 38-32 as of right now. And then NJCU travels down to Rutgers Camden, face off in South Jersey at 3 p.m. as well. This one, like we said, an 11-point lead for the Ospreys. Haven't shot the ball too efficiently, 30% from the field, 21% from three. And probably highlighting the struggles all around is DJ Campbell. He does have 8 points, but he's 2 of 11 from the field and 1 of 7 from beyond the arc. Would like to get him going a little bit more efficiently because he's getting the looks he likes. The Ospreys will start with the ball to start the second half, and we are underway in the final half of regulation. Dawkins, Flanders, Lawrence, Dunsack, and Campbell on the floor for the Ospreys. The initial starting five for Stockton. Same thing on the other side. Myers, Gorman, Rooney, Bladen, and Kendall for Ramapo. Dunsack misses on his first shot of the second half. Now Gorman outside. Dished outside to Kendall. Kendall asks for a screen, finds himself free, will spin move, drive inside the layup. Not enough. Off the mark that time. Lawrence takes things the other way, met by Rooney. Flanders now back over to Lawrence. Lawrence, Dawkins. Dawkins working on the elbow. Again will work for the perimeter. Driving inside, kick out for three. Out of bounds. Said Dawkins. That is foot out of bounds when he caught the pass. So a wasted possession for the Ospreys. A minute down, no score. No scoring in the second half, at least. 11-point hill to climb for the Ospreys to get it started. We'll get a trip to the line here. Myers almost an end one as he was driving baseline. It was a good look. Dunsack's first of the second half, second of the game. It's been a lot of the free throw game for both sides. Myers, first shot off the back iron, no good. 11 for 13 now from the line is Ramapo. Bulk of their points from the charity stripe. Second one connects. That's a 10-point game. Take things up, here's Dawkins. Dawkins over to Lawrence. Lawrence gets the screen, now Dunsack back over, tic-tac-toe, here's Campbell. Now Dawkins outside, Lawrence for three. Bang! Got it to go. Extends the lead. Lawrence's fifth point of the day. Needing an answer desperately. Here's Ramapo. Can't afford to let another run happen. Gorman will dish outside. Again, working for the perimeter. Gorman pump fakes. Now to Kendall. Kendall will drive in. Now over to Myers. Myers gets the ball swiped away. Still a struggle for it. Stockton has it. Dawkins the other way. Starts a possession. Campbell for three. Got it. Timeout called by Ramapo. The Roadrunners call time after two big shots by the Ospreys, and DJ Campbell connects on that one. Hits on his first three of the second half, gives him 11 on the day. And we talked about needing to get him open, needing to get him shots, but really the struggles for Ramapo haven't been too much defensively. Sure, allowing 41 points at this stage isn't necessarily great, but you could stay in ball games doing that. However, the 25 that they have isn't going to keep them in things, and a bulk of that comes through their lack of a perimeter game, lack of their work from beyond the arc, only two shots from distance. It's really showing why they can't get going offensively, because you know where the ball is going. They're working inside. It's the Ben Simmons happy offense, you could say, because they're not shooting threes, not taking the shots from distance, and you gotta expect that to change just because of how congested the paint is as of right now. Look at things in the end, Jack. Ramapo, fourth best three-point shooting team. However, they only hit three per game on average. Rooney inside, working, spin move, puts up the fadeaway shot, takes a few jumps and rattles home. Only three made three-pointers a game for Ramapo. That's worse than the NJAC. Stockton on the other side, second best in the NJAC, averaging almost 11. Lawrence, Campbell, hop step, go inside, gets it popped up at the elbow, finds the ball back in his hands. Lawrence now outside, Dunsack, three ball on a line, no good. Offensive board by Dunsack, right back to him. Flanders, Campbell, guarded by Kendall. Gets a screen from Dunzak, splits defenders, loses the ball, now has it. Somehow finds a way to pass it out. Five on the shot clock, pulls up, and no. Lawrence couldn't get it to connect, was collapsed on in the corner. Myers, long pass across, Gorman for three. Can't knock it down. Offensive board by Rooney. Rooney tried to put it back up. Campbell swatted it away. Now the pass too strong, trying to get in transition, but a foul called against Bladen. Jordan Williams will check in for Dunsack. Dawkins takes things off the inbound, met by Gorman, working at the Osprey logo, driving in hard to the paint, puts up a hard floater, and then swipes it away. Tried to get it to go, but right back and lost it. We'll pad the stat a little bit. Second steal of the game, unofficially, for Keon Flanders. Can't get a shot off, so it was just swiped away. Gorman, in need of a bucket. Pulls up for three. Got it! Peter Gorman, the South Amboy native, connects on that one. Give him his first bucket of the day. One of six from the field, one of two from distance. Lawrence will spin move, drive in, try to get the pass out to Campbell, but got it picked off and tipped away. Defensively in transition, the Osprey playing very well. Swipe the other way. Here's Dawkins. Dawkins in transition. Euro step layup. Good. And again, a run from Stockton. Timeout, Ospreys. It's a 30-second timeout. We'll keep things here. 13-point lead for Stockton. Around 4.5 minutes down. We take a look elsewhere around the NJAC. Montclair stayed out to a bigger lead at this point, 11-point lead, 47-36 over TCNJ. The Profs of Rowan University with a 58-38 lead over Kane and the Cougars, 20-point lead in that one. And the two games yet to square off, NJCU, Rutgers Camden, and Boone-Patterson, and Rutgers North. So far in both those games, coming off the bench, Mike Jackson with 15 points. This Jersey City native from Montclair State with 15 on 50% shooting for the Redhawks. And then for the Rowan Kane game, Andrew Seeger got 13 in double figures. Here, DJ Campbell leads all scorers with 11. 3 of 12 from the field, 2 of 8 from distance. Corbeau gets it right back, swung out again, pulled up for the 3, but a little too late. Board popped up, almost had it for the Roadrunners, but they lost it. In transition, here's Dawkins. Dawkins spins around, has to give off. Campbell over to Lawrence. Lawrence swung one more time, a travel call. Leave against Lawrence. Travel called on the opposite end. Howell called that time, so back-to-back possessions, same result, and they're both not good. Take things up, Dawkins trying to get an offensive possession. We'll give things over to Lawrence. Lawrence now Campbell. Campbell back Dawkins. Dawkins back Lawrence, top of the key. Goes between his legs. Now off Campbell. Three ball. Bounces off the rim and out of play. It's just been a tough day from the field for DJ Campbell. One of the most efficient shooters in the NJAC. Shoots around 44% consistently and from beyond the arc, a 40% shooter. Average around 18 points per game, fourth in the New Jersey Athletic Conference. Today, hasn't been as efficient. Corbeau to drive, spins around, puts up the floater, again off the mark. Offensive board, second chance, third chance, fourth chance. Out of bounds. Three offensive rebounds on that possession. So the inbound here, take things off the inbound. It's Warren. Mansfield Warren will set things up. Outside Corbeau. Corbeau gives off Howell. Finds Warren open free. Now back over to Howell. 8 on the shot clock. Howell to drive. Fade away from the elbow. Off the mark and an over the back call. Things flip the other way. It's called that time. Shane Rooney. Rooney's second of the game. Dawkins takes things off the inbound, will lead things across the timeline. Now over to the wing, to Flanders. A lot of movement by this Ospreys offense. Campbell, back over Dawkins. Again, taking it right back. Lawrence, opposite side, they'll work. Campbell finding himself free, 5 on the shot clock, now gives off Dawkins for 3. Can't go. Corbeau with the board. 13-point ball game, 13 minutes left to play. Howell, stutter step, gives off to Warren. Corbeau back over. Howell has to give off. Corbeau again, running the same movements, driving inside, and blocking foul called that time. Kion Flanders called only his first. The Wildwood, New Jersey native. Dropped inside, looking for a shot. Corbeau off the mark, has struggled from inside. Now quickly the other way, the Ospreys look for a transition bucket. Dawkins to drive, now inside, foul called. Azzurro is going to the line. Chance two at the line here, extending the lead to 15. Zorro hits. Take a look at the points in the paint totals for both these squads. Dead even at 12 apiece, but really been a struggle for anyone to get going, but more specifically Ramapo, because a majority of their offense facilitates through the paint. Zorro with the shimmy. Gets it to go. Goes 2-for-2 from the line there. Gorman out met by a double. Has to give off. Rooney trying to get the pass inside to Kendall. Kendall trapped underneath. Gorman will save things out. Gets the screen. Warren outside Kendall. Kendall, ball on the floor, has to pass it out. Gorman, five on the shot clock. Look to drive. Now Kendall for three. Warren for three. Got it! Mansfield Warren got it to go. His fifth of the game. Campbell gets the screen, gets the mismatch on Rooney. Tried to pass inside. Now gives off inside. Lawrence and one. Rynell Lawrence with a chance for one more. Dawkins will check out. Jamar Johnson will hop in for the Ospreys. Lawrence off the mark. Offensive board. Big time. Lawrence for three. Got it! Says, I won't take the three-point play. I'll just take three more. Rooney drops things down. Big body play to score the two. Brian Joseph connects that time. Lawrence gives off. Now Johnson. Johnson. Campbell. Top of the key. Pump fake. Step back. Now outside Lawrence. Lawrence will slow down the offense a bit. Work from the Osprey logo. And will drive to the cup. And a foul called on Rooney. It's a mismatch. They might want to exploit a little bit more. Down here. Lawrence checks out of the ball game. And a loose ball foul that time called on the Osprey, so they don't get an inbound. We'll just check things over. Ramapo trailing by 15 at this stage of the ball game. 11 minutes left to play. Still time, but need a whole lot to come. Looking for the lob to Kendall. Can't get it to go and drop things back down. Believe they called a foul on the shot. So Zorro called with a foul on Kendall. So he'll go to the line here for two. Kendall, excellent from the line so far today. Perfect, 7-for-7 from the charity stripe. Looking for a big hit of two here. And does, perfect from the line so far today. Loses control. Now Warren outside. Gorman got the steal, the three, got it! Peter Gorman got the steal off the inbound, then hits the three. It's a 10-point ball game. Timeout called by Stockton. It's a 30-second timeout. We're going to keep things here. 11 minutes left to play, and a little bit of momentum shifting towards the Roadrunners after that one. Gorman now 6 points, 2 of 3 from beyond the arc, and don't know what it's going to take to get them out of this 10-point hill to climb, get them up that mountain. But it looks like they may have found something. Playing a little bit more aggressively defensively, going after the ball and not playing the man, not playing the shot, and working with a little bit of a press. Would like to see that three ball get used more. It's now 4 of 7 from beyond the arc, 57% on the day. Starts on the defensive end as Dawkins will cross the timeline for the Ospreys. Gives off Campbell. Campbell back off Dawkins. Now Flanders back off Campbell. The guard trio giving it back to back to back. One more time driving inside with the sky hook off the mark. Gorman with the offensive board, with the defensive board for the Roadrunners. Looking for a drive now back outside Warren. Warren will look to cross court. Will pull from the corner. Off the mark. Offensive board by Ramapo. Warren, open for three. Hesitated. Allowed the Ospreys to get there. 10 on the shot clock. An illegal screen call that time against Brian Joseph. And that's got to be frustrating for the Roadrunners. But you could already tell the lack of respect in the long distance shot, as Isaiah Hall had a look from deep. DJ Campbell gave him room, still bricked it. Campbell, he's definitely going to be guarded from beyond the arc. One of the best shooters in the NJAC. De Los Santos for three, can't go, out of bounds. Stays a 10-point game. Less than 10 to play. Gorman will give off. Opposite side, here's Warren, now Kendall. Kendall over to Gorman. Gorman met by a double. Back over, Gorman again in the corner, drops things towards the elbow. Hop step, puts up the little floater, can't connect. Offensive board again, Joseph puts up the shot, he's fouled. So Joseph going to the line here for two. He's perfect from the line as well today. 4 for 4 from the charity stripe. Make your free throws, you'll stay in ball games. That's why the Roadrunners cutting away. Can't make that one though. Joseph, around 67% from the line on the year. The 6'3 freshman forward from Jersey City will set up and cut the deficit to single digits. 9-point game, 50-41. 9 minutes left to play. Dawkins, guarded by Gorman. Williams sets the screen. They switch off again with the switch. Campbell now. Campbell trying to pass out, and a travel call against DJ Campbell, who's been quiet since the early stages in this half. Had a big three at the beginning of the half, but ever since, nothing doing. He has 11. 8 of them coming in the first half of basketball. Gorman switches positions on the court, gives off, now drop down, almost swiped away, the little sky hook rattles home. Isaiah Hall gets a bucket that time. He's got 5. 50% from the field. Driving around, gives off for 3. Would be big, can't go. Rebounded by the Roadrunners. Warren gives off, almost swiped away. Ramapo still has it, and they'll save almost a disaster situation on the fast break. Gorman working from the point. 8 minutes left. Switches to the wing, pulls up, deep three. Got it! Huge three by Peter Gorman. Makes it a 4-point ball game. He's got 9, all from deep. Timeout called by the Ospreys. This will be a full timeout. 4-point ball game. The Ospreys still lead, but have been scoreless for the last 4 minutes. 13-0 run in that time span for Ramapo, and have found their way from beyond the arc, 3 of 4 on their last 4 from distance. Peter Gorman himself is that 3 of 4. 75% from deep today is Peter Gorman on the year. Around 32% is the freshman South Amboy. Played his high school ball on the shore. Mater Dei Prep was first team all division, second team all division, and third team all shore. Just some accolades from his time at Mater Dei. Today, he's been big. 9 points, just below his season average of 11. But bulk of that, all of that coming from distance. Typically shocking for the Roadrunners to get that three to fall, like we said. Worse than the NJAC in field goals made from distance. Averaging only around 3 per game. Dawkins in need of a bucket. Well, dishing out, losing control. Flanders will save it. Swiped away, heading the other way. Here comes Ramapo. The other way, the bucket. In transition, it's good. Mansfield Warren makes it a 2-point ball game. Campbell, long three to silence the run. He can't. It's off the mark, off the backboard. Rebounded by Ramapo, and a foul called against the Ospreys. A chance to tie it up. Excuse me, it was a foul against Ramapo. So we'll stay here. Saw a black jersey on the floor. But now it's a 1-1. Brown and Glover. No points on the day. Glover shooting from the line at a 78% clip. Connects on that one. Make it a 3-point game. Two for two from the line on the 1-1, so now it's a 4-point game. 2-possession lead for Stockton. Gorman dishes off. Now to Warren. Warren to Kendall. Back over Gorman. Gorman picks up his dribble. Back off Warren. Gorman for three. Can't connect. And rebounded by Stockton and Flanders. Flanders now outside to Lawrence. Back over Flanders. Flanders pushing Gorman out. Will drive. And forced a kick out. Campbell outside. He'll reconvene. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Hard defense being played here by Joseph. Step back. Trey. And the foul! Campbell. A step back three. Connects. And a trip to the line for one more. Biggest shot of the game, DJ Campbell. Silence the run. 14 points. And that one's the biggest. Points now for DJ Campbell. And makes it an 8-point ball game. Just like that. Ramapo is silenced. Desperately in need of a bucket once more. Kendall from the wing gives off Gorman. Gorman opposite side to Warren. Now Gorman again dropped inside. Back outside Gorman. Gorman will look to drive. Gets a big layup to go. 6-point game. He's got 11. Gorman's been huge in the second half. Ball almost swiped away, but a reach-in foul called against Isaiah Hall. The Roadrunner faithful not ecstatic about that call. First bucket connects. So now 7-point game. Dawkins at the line here. Perfect. Back out to 8. Still time. 6 minutes left to go. Ramapo down by 8. Kendall over to Gorman. Gorman met by a double again. The zone working incredibly well for the Ospreys. Pull up, Trey off the back iron and rebounded by Rhino Lawrence. But a jump ball actually called. Looked like Lawrence had it, but a jump ball called nevertheless, and the possession arrow favoring the Roadrunners. Gorman inbound, spinning around. Both teams spinning around. Outside now, here's Warren. Warren gets it, gives off Gorman. Gorman facilitating the offense, calls a screen. We'll look to drive again, kicked out to Hall. Hall gets it swiped away, but a foul called instead. Lawrence called for the foul. So another inbound here, 20 seconds on the shot clock. Again, an 8-point lead for the Ospreys. Be a big upset if they can get it. For the Roadrunners, step back. Couldn't get the shot off. Warren finds himself free. Pull up, Trey. Rattles home. Found himself free with the crossover, then stepped back to the 3-point line and makes it a 5-point game. Lawrence outside will get it right back. Now to Campbell. Campbell looking to silence things. The pass outside, but a travel. Shot won't count. That's huge. Had Kion Flanders wide open. Wide open for 3. And he hit it. But didn't count because of the travel. Kendall outside Gorman. Big possession for both sides. Gorman, around 5 minutes left. Kendall gets a screen. Working against Lawrence, will body his way in. Puts up the layup, can't go. Williams with the offensive board, with the defensive board. Dawkins now with it. Dawkins, looking to slow things down, waste some time. Kicks out to the corner. Back outside Dawkins, now Lawrence swung right to left. Dawkins again will now drive, puts up the layup, rims out, gets his own rebound. Jump ball call, the possession arrow favoring the Ospreys, so things will stay with Stockton. The Ospreys call timeout. It's a full timeout. We'll keep things here. Take a look elsewhere around the NJAC. 2 games currently going on. 1 actually just went final. Montclair State took down TCNJ by a wide margin, 71-53. Your final from Montclair, New Jersey. The Panzer Athletic Center. The women's game will be squaring off later on today. They will get the late tip-off, similar to here, 3 p.m. tip-off for Red Hawks and Lions in the women's side of things. Elsewhere, the Profs of Rowan University with a large lead over the Kane Cougars, 85-67, 4:30 left to play in the second half of action. two players in double, well in double figures, four players in double figures for the Profs. Ariana Zemi and Andrew Seeger both have 16 for Rowan. Elsewhere for Kane, Latrell West actually leads all scorers with 17 points on the day. Hot day for Mike Jackson, led the Montclair State Redhawks to a big victory over TCNJ. He finishes with 18 points, 4 steals and 5 boards for Jackson and the Redhawks. Irvin Callender the fourth, one of the best rebounders in the NJAC, finished with 9, short of double digits in that contest. Back to live action. 4:16 left to play in the second half. The Ospreys to inbound. Up by 5. Williams gets it. Dawkins over to Campbell. 3 ball. Too short. Offensive board all the way back out to Lawrence. And that's huge. Big offensive board. Needing the rebound a little bit better is Ramapo getting stuck inside, and a foul called in the double bonus, so we'll go to the line for 2. Lawrence will go here for 2. It's 2 for 5 from the free throw line today. 10 points, 3 of 6 from the field, 2 of 4 from distance. Second on the team in points today. Give him 11 now. Six-point game, trying to make it a 7-point game. Lawrence hits on the second. Entering today, 78% shooter from the line. So Gorman down by 7. Try and operate something. Kendall back over Gorman. Gorman will drop inside. Now finds himself free. Give off Warren, taking a lot of time to operate this offense. 10 on the shot clock. Gorman now back outside Warren. Warren's gonna have to drive. Eurostep layup off the mark. Campbell gets the offensive board. We'll slow things down, give it out to Lawrence, and they'll kill some more clock. Up by 7. Would like a bucket. Almost took it with Flanders. Now finds himself free. He'll take this one though for 3. Got it. Kion Flanders makes it a 10-point game once more. And Ramapo is back to scoreless in the last 2 minutes. We'll leave another full timeout called by Ramapo. As they trail by 10 now, and this game just a moment ago was only a 4-point game. Ramapo has yet to lead the contest. Getting his first bucket. Went to Stockton and they never looked back. Spent around 95% of the ball game with the lead. Haven't been tied since the first 2 minutes. 2 minutes of scoreless action for Ramapo in a time where they needed a bucket. They haven't been able to get it. Can't buy a bucket in tough spots, and that's been the story of the game so far. A lot of that due to the good interior defense by the Ospreys. Get a look at some more numbers. 3 players in double figures for Stockton. DJ Campbell leads the way with 15. Right now Lawrence with 12 and Kion Flanders with 10 points. 3 players with 5 boards as well. Dawkins, Dunsack, and Campbell all with 5. Dawkins with a pretty darn good stat line. 6 points, 5 boards, 5 assists, 2 steals and a block. 34 minutes played. Leads a ball game in almost all of those stats, except for points and steals. Myers tried to draw a blocking foul called against Williams. Jordan Williams third. He's got 7 points on the day, all coming in the first half. Myers with a trip to the line here. Myers 1-for-2 from the stripe today. Off the mark, make him 1-for-3. So no good on the 1-and-1 attempt. Stockton can hold a little bit longer here. On the clock all the way down to 2.5 minutes. Make things even more tough as Williams will pull for three. Won't go, offensive board can kill more clock. They'll hold. Dawkins working from near the logo. Campbell sets the screen. Dawkins again finds himself free. We'll work around, finds himself open for the shot, won't go. Another runner, but another offensive board. Can run this clock all the way down to 2 minutes now. Got a whole extra 30 seconds with some offensive rebounds. Dawkins back over Campbell. Campbell with five. Five to shoot, pulls up for three. Got it! DJ Campbell, 18 points. He's find his way a little bit from three. Warren to answer. Off the mark, bangs out of bounds and going the other way. Last touch by Ramapo. A little bit shocking to see Campbell hit another one crazily from distance. Flailed his legs out on the deep shot, and it still went in. Campbell again finds himself free, dribbling some clock out. 15 seconds as the Ospreys, with a 13-point lead, will look to advance to 14-3 overall and 9-2 in end-jack play. Campbell will drive, pull up with a fadeaway shot as it swishes right back in. He's got 20 now. Kendall driving, he's fouled. Keith Kendall called for, got fouled. Go to the line here. Leads Ramapo in scoring. This is a game of points from the line. 8 of 8 from the charity stripe. Off the mark, offensive board, but I believe foul called. Correction. It's not a 1-and-1 anymore. Team fouls exceed the limit. In the double bonus is Ramapo. So Kendall on the second. Connects. First miss of the game for Kendall. Gorman working on the press against Dawkins. Dawkins long pass to Campbell, keeps his feet in. Spin move, trying to find himself, gives off Dawkins, 1 minute remaining. Dawkins now with it, Campbell splits defenders, he's fouled. Dawkins dishes in the first shot. 5-for-4 from the line. Excuse me, 5-for-6 from the line, trying to make it 6-for-7. 5-for-7. 21 points on the day for DJ Campbell. Subs come in for the Ospreys with a big lead at this point. A little layup goes in for Myers. Jordan Williams checks out, and Nick Pellegrini will come in. Travel called against the Ospreys. 13 3-point lead with 43 seconds left. More substitutions come in. DJ Campbell will stay in the game. Kane Dawkins will hop out. Jordan Heck comes in for Stockton. Gorman pump fakes, looking to drive, met by a double, and the ball goes now out of bounds. Hit off the official. So last touch by the official, but does not count for possession-wise. Pass out of bounds by Ramapo. Campbell will just pop things back in. Flanders will find himself free and try and dribble out some clock here. Again to Campbell. Campbell met by a double. 25 seconds left. Not going to foul. Outside Heck. Heck from the corner will look to go in. The layup. It's good. You find yourself free. You got to shoot it. Warren drains it from deep. Too little, too late. As now here's Campbell. Campbell just running out the clock. As that will do it. Stockton advances to 14-3 and 9-2 in conference play with a 71-59 win over the Ramapo College Roadrunners. Ramapo falls to 4-10 overall now on the year. And 3-8 now in NJAC play. Big day for DJ Campbell. Found himself a lot better in that final half, down to the final 5 minutes really. 6 of 18 from the field, 4 of 13 from beyond the arc. Not the best day in terms of percentages, however, 21 points and 6 boards will get it done. 31 minutes played. Elsewhere, right now, Lawrence, Kion Flanders, both were in double digits. Lawrence with 12 and Flanders with 10. And then elsewhere for the Ospreys, Kadian Dawkins. Finished with 6 points, 6 boards, and 5 assists, 1 block, 2 steals in 36 minutes played for the Ospreys. On the other side, Marquise Kendall, 13 points, tied for the team lead, as also Mansfield Warren finished with 13 later on in the contest. Once again, this one is final. Wrapping things up from Galloway, New Jersey, I'm Gary Ridley. On the campus of Stockton University, where the final score is 71-59, as Stockton takes down Ramapo to go to 14-3 overall on the year. This has been Stockton basketball on the Stockton Sports Network.